All right, we are live. It's pretty late now. It's here. It's 2 a.m. I'm in my sleep shirt. I took a nap in the evening just now. Very bad timing. So now I have to finish my work. And, yeah. Okay, let's see. I'm trying to finish this in maybe in half an hour or so, I don't know. Usually, probably it'll take longer than this. Hold on. Okay, but the point of today's stream is that I want to implement correctly, because I did so yesterday incorrectly, the Hamiltonian Monte Carlo with a exponential integration time, which is simply an geometric number of leapfrog steps, essentially. That's what we're doing. So just a refresher, so let me just look at the geometric distribution. So it has the p is a success rate, I believe. Yes, the parameter is p. It's between 0 and 1, strictly larger than 0, and you are describing the number of steps it takes before it refreshes, right? So I think you can say that the number of needed to get one success, so something like this. And Bernoulli trials is essentially saying that it's a coin toss. It's a coin toss with some probability, right? Of course, in this case, it would be an uneven coin, an unfair coin, bias coin, I don't know how you call it. Okay, so require a few things. So currently my code is kind of messy and I don't really like it, but I just hope it stays intact until I get the results that I want. Okay. So uniform draws, so okay, basically if I set the mean to be a certain way, then it would be 1 over p, right? The mean is simply just 1 over p. Yes. So it's simply 1 over p. That means to say that my current implementation is wrong. So if I take the number of leapfrog steps, okay, there's two ways I can go about this. One is that I can emulate, okay, wait, there's two ways I can go about this, yeah. So one is I can treat it as a Hamiltonian Monte Carlo, in the sense that I generate geometric distributed variable number for the number of leapfrog steps and do a full refresh every time. And I do not record in between, in between distances. Or I could treat it as a like a mala, but with a variable, well, with a geometric refresh rate, right? That's kind of how to see it. So I have I think I can programmatically do the one that I want here. So if I want my hold on, I think these are all kind of wrong. Let me just comment that out temporarily. Let me just look at this and then just kind of think about this in a more sensible manner. Oh boy. Okay, so I have some key, and then I have my chains and samples, and this is my uniform draws. And then I have P. So this P, let's just say that it's 1 over 10. Well, let's say L equals 10. L, and then we define L equals 10. oopsie daisy. Da, da, da. And then the geometric draws, and if I plot the histogram of geometric draws, the flan, for example, let's say bins, I don't know, 30, I should see that it should be just going down. And then the mean, and of course if I just take the geometric draws dot mean, should be like 10. Okay, that's very good. So wait, why is it let's say density equals true. I should look the same here. But let me think. That's interesting. Now, what I want to do is to consider I did not mean to do that. I could stop it, but okay, let's say 10 and then 20 and then 50. So they should look like all slopes, but each one kind of lower and then kind of fatter the end. Alpha equals 0.5 actually. Okay, let's oopsie daisy. Yeah, that looks about right. Max. Whoa, and the max is 126. What the heck? What? That means. Ooh. I guess this is what. Okay, I'm gonna try to finish this in half an hour because my food is gonna come. I have had a late lunch at about 5, and that's about it. So. Like 4, 5, and now I am hungry. Okay, so this is easy. I mean, I don't know. It means once in a while it'll take 126 steps. It's kind of crazy, right? Wait, why is it tripping up? What is the shape? So there should just be 10 lines, right? Why is it so difficult? In any case, what I have here I think works pretty well. So essentially what I did before was just kind of unnecessary. I don't need any of these things. So geometric draws would be my NLF steps. That's kind of cool. So I jitter it, and then NLF steps. So if is none, else if constant number of leapfrog steps. Yeah, I feel like this implementation is really, really bad. Okay, so if there's nothing, then it's just 1, right? int? No, it's just n chains times n samples. That's it, right? And if it's an integer, then nlf steps multiply by then if it's dependent on the number of chains, then I'll do this for each chain. So that means at least each chain number of samples. So for each chain, that means each chain can have a different number of leapfrog steps, that's correct. And then within the samples, it's going to be constant. Okay, and if I jitter it further, that means it's going to be taken as, hold up. Okay, this is the, okay, if I jitter it, that means to say I want my mean. Okay, that means to say this would have to be 1 divided by so p equals to 1 divided by nlf steps. So this have to be negative p here. And then on the other hand, if I have normal, then okay, I think I need to test this code out just to make sure that I'm sane. Oh, what the heck. Yeah, okay, on average, it's alright. What am I thinking, too? So this implementation is a little bit scary for me. So let's just say that I am... you know what? Let me just do all this in its entirety. Why not? Just to make sure that it works. Of course, let me just be careful. There's no J here. There's no J in this house. Here. And here. Okay. So let's just say that this is none. Ooh, NLF steps. Ah, okay. And it would just be 1 all over. And if it's 5, constant only works at 5 all over. Now if it's, let's say if it's LF list, wait, LF list is not defined. Oh, LF grid dot flatten. Yeah, okay, I'll upgrade off flatten. Let's see here. But it would be a, wouldn't there be a clash in the... Okay. So this shouldn't work at all because of the size difference. Well, let's just use a key, right? Why not? There should be a size difference, right? Okay, yeah, okay. So this one, let's just say that I am doing, let's just say that a range from 1 to n plus chains plus 1. That means, let me just make it clear. It will be 1 to 10, brilliant. Okay, that means it'll be 10 times 10 is 1000. So let's just look at the second one. If I just plot this out, it'd be twos and ones. Very good. If I plot the first one, it'd just be all ones. If I plot the second one, it'd be one and two and three. Very good. And this would be a uniform. So if I do the histogram, I should expect just flat all over. Very good. Okay, brilliant. Now, I will need to use the mean, and this is gonna be a, hopefully it works. I don't see why it wouldn't work, but things don't always, yeah, of course things don't work because I do them. Oh, it works, huh. Oh shit, okay. So let me just make it very clear. So uniform draws dot shape, this would be 10 times 10,000, and then the P shape would be 10 times 10,000. So seal, blah blah blah. So in the end, my NLF steps is gonna be the right size. Okay, but zero is a problem because one. Wait, hold up. How do you get zero here? What the hell? NLF steps, 1D type, NLF steps. It's one, yes. The uniform draws. Oh, because it's ceiling. Oh, it's ceiling though. Wait, hold up. Wait, let me just make sure. Uniform to geometric variable. I can't even spell. Oh, there's one viewer. Welcome. Oh, I have it. Oops, shoot. Hello? Okay. Hello? Yeah, okay, I'm coming. Okay, thank you. Yeah, I'm coming, yeah. Hello? What? Is he asking me to come down now or what? My phone is trash. Okay, I think, okay, let me just quickly look this up so that I can think about it on my way down. Yes. Yeah, there we go. Minus long U, long minus P U must be uniformly distributed. It's geometrically distributed. Log U, log one minus P. Log minus P is integer. Hello? Okay, coming, thank you. All right, coming, thanks. All right. Okay, I'm gonna head down to get my food. All right, I got quite a big pack of food. It's for two meals, two and a half meals, just to make the delivery worth it. Okay. Okay, where were we? Ah, yes. Uniform. Let's actually do something different. Oh, what am I doing? What am I changing in here? Pfft, idiot. Okay, so anyway, I have this going on, but why would it be zero? 1 divided by 1 log 1 0. Is that what it is? Yeah, so log 1 minus, wait, log 1 minus 1 log 0. So I can't actually do this, can I? Be a problematic thing. No, 1 plus, no. It'd be infinite. Yes. So let's just check something. 0.mean is the average 2. Wait, no. First one, average is 2. Second one, average is 3. Average is 4. Average is 5. Average is 6. That's fine. Okay, so it's the first case that is a bit problematic. So if on average we want it to be 1, wait, how can that be? Hold on, something is off. Yeah, we only want it to be 1, right? We can't let it be, So it'll be 0 to 1, and then 1. I see. And then, okay, let's try, what if we do, what if the first row, oh, well, okay, maybe I can try something like this. What if this is, instead of 1, it's very close to 1. Maybe quite close to 1. An average is 1, and then you can do the mean, whatever. 1.05, sure. So if it is negative 1, we want to make it to be quite close to negative 1, but not exactly negative 1. So this is gonna be a problem. Can I just minus from everything? Would that be very criminal? So instead of 1, I would, instead of 1, it would be 5, I don't know. Zero. Zero times something is always zero. Okay. Can I use that? No. Oh wait, I have a solution. What a cheeky thing that I did. I can do min, right? I can do that. Yes, I can do np dot maximum 1. Yeah, that solves everything. Very good. And just make sure that you have at least one leapfrog step. Then you mean x is 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. It's brilliant. And I think this works. So I think I just gotta put this here. JMP maximum. Okay. Yes. Okay, yeah. So let me just make it a bit of a let's just say that this let's just call it that, and then and samples underscore is just 5, just for the fun of it. And LF steps. Great, we can make it 10 actually. Very good, I think 10 gets the point across. And if I do like a uniform, oh hey. Of course, silly mistakes as always. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah. Yeah, so let me just oh hey, why is it like this? From 1, if I want it to be on 1 on average, if I want it to be 2, it must be, if I want it to be 2, it must be 2x minus 1. Oh, hey. Okay, this is not so straightforward. Wait. Come on, this is easy, right? So if I want it to be 2, that means on average, I need it to be between 1 and... inclusive of 3. So it's just 2x is fine, I believe. Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yeah, so that means the average would simply be this plus this divided by 2, right? Right, if I do 1, it will just be 1 plus 3 divided by 2, 1.5. Wait, what? Wait, this is exclusive. So it's 1 times 2, 1 plus 2, 3 minus 2, 2 divided by 2 equals 1. Yeah. Yeah, one of my
1 plus L divided by 2 equals P. So P equals L minus 1.
So just 2L is fine. Yeah. Yeah, okay. If we make it into, you know, larger size, it'll be more accurate. Right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Brilliant. So that means I gotta change that too. It's pretty stupid that I did that. I don't know why. Maximum lambda. I change all of the individual ones. That's good. That's good. Jitter. 1 divided by. Yep. Minus p. Yep. Yep. And then, of course, if I do not jitter, let's just call it x, then call it 10, then it would be 1, 2, 0, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10. Very well. If I make it just 5, and if I make it 5, what would it be? It would be a problem because it doesn't make any sense. And that's fair. This is super fair. Okay, this is great. This all works brilliantly and I'm very happy. So this is gonna work just fine. Great. Now the last thing I need to work out is how to emulate the Mala approach, right? Which is to say that So the probability, I've done this calculations a million times, but I keep on forgetting. But so if I refer to my submission, with probability P equals 1 minus this, is fully refreshed, right? And what I want is, so I want to inject P like this, and then so the expected, so this would be 1 over L on average, right? On average. And the probability, and then L will be 1 over P. Yeah, that's right. So I know L, so I know this. So if I work backwards, so it would be like this equals 1 minus 1 over L. I log it, make it negative. So log 1 minus 1 over L divided by negative delta equals to kappa. That's what I need. And then I can say that this is log 1 plus negative 1 over L divided by delta. And this, and interestingly, this is suspiciously similar to what I have here. Why is it like that? Oh, I mean, I guess it's not super confused or like super hard to figure out. Okay, so I have another extra. So let's see, let's get kappa, wait, LF, the multiproc steps, 2 update rate, and then let's call it L, and then I need a step size 2, and then I will need to return simply np dot log 1 plus negative 1 over L divided by negative step size. Huh. Very good. So let's just be quite clear about this as well. Oh, I shouldn't have, should have deleted that stuff. Okay. Let me just keep this temporarily, and then I have what do you call it again? I have steps 2, update rate, and then I have L and I have step size, and I have to return, what is it? Log 1p negative 1 over L divided by negative SS, something like that. Yep, straightforward. So what I want to do is then use this to trick my, actually I don't really need this anymore actually. It's great. Doesn't matter. Okay. So this is a bit tricky here. Okay, let me just look at my grid. Something like this. Okay, so that's my grid, and then this is So I want to have my corresponding update rate. Let's just see if this works. Inf. Oh, 1 minus. Wait, 1 plus? 1 minus L divided by delta. Right. So I can't make it inf, but I can just make it quite big, right? So I can say like something like maximum, minimum. 10e 1e8, get a bunch of numbers, very well. And then this is gonna be my kappa. It's gonna be pretty stupid, but if I take kappa and so I take 1 minus kappa times SS HMC times grid. This is P. Yep, precisely, yeah. I get what I want. So, okay. So this is kappa. Very well. Actually, so I'm done. Hey, it's not so bad. Okay, so now I need to run the experiments and make sure that I'm doing the right things. Okay, so this experiment is rather quick to run actually. Okay, so it's 0 to 9. Okay, now that I can do 30, actually I might want to do more. So let's try 60. Number of step size 30. See if that works. Great. And then okay, so now I need to be a bit careful. Oh shoot, I need to define my It's not so bad, it's not so bad. So for generalized HMC, I want to have the same tuning. I'd have the same problem with tuning I as well. So let me quickly do a new view so that I can do the same ESJD, because I'm trying to track all the ESJDs, which is a little bit tricky, you might imagine. And cheating is a little bit tricky now, because I need to figure out very clearly what I want to get out of this. So if it's AR, then there's nothing much that I can study. I can look at the positions, and then I can take away, I can go, okay, let's be very, very meticulous about this. So first of all, I want to make sure that I'm understanding this correctly, because okay, so already there's a thinning thing that is happening that I wasn't doing previously already. That's kind of want to be careful about that. Okay, so thinning, okay, so I thin and then I get there, then towards the end I have this exact thing here. Bah, bah, bah. Bah. Oof, what the heck. Am I... Whoa. Okay. So it is the same thing, just that I have a J plus 1, J plus 2 factor here. And then of course, if I move this down, it looks so bad. Okay, never mind. Okay, this is fine. And then I have my... So this would be the usual generalized HMC. And now I'm going to add a section that is similar, but I'm gonna call it freely. So generalized HMC with geometric full refresh. So the idea is, well, it's not, but the point is I want it to emulate generalized, huh. Okay, so generalized, and then what I want here is I have the tracking of the ESJD. This is very, very specific, and this is would be the ESJD just for the bounds, right? So it would be the same as the refresh. Number of settings, oh okay, it's not so straightforward. Yeah, because the number of settings here is number of step size time of update rate, but now I'm taking number of step size HMC, number of step settings HM. So actually I should follow the HMC method. Okay, now this is very tricky. So the UR grid, so SS HMC, I should follow the HMC variables here. And then I have my LF grid. And then I want to define, this is important here. Okay, wait. Where did I write this? Goodness. Didn't I just write this? Wait, where did I? Oh my god. Did I delete it? A freaking idiot. Wait. Let's just search for update rate. Yes. Did I freaking delete it away? Thank God, I mean, wait. Dumb piece of shit, okay. What did I just do? Okay. Let's call this GHMC, HMC. GHMC with geometric refresh. So the point is that I can obviously, but I want to emulate HMC here. So that's the kind of the point here. Is that UR grid HMC. I don't know if that's the right way to write it. UR HMC grid. Okay. So I would say LF to UR LF SS. Once again, UR equals to MP dot log 1 plus 1 minus 1 minus 1 plus minus 1 over L LF divided by negative SS. And then return maximum 1E8 UR. Okay, and UR HMC would be LF to UR LF grid, I would say. LF grid and then SS HMC grid. So I would have the same number as shape 30 30. Yeah, let's do 58. Let me choose 58. Steps. LF grid. Very well. Okay, so now I have UR HMC grid, and this is gonna be such a mess. I can already see it. Doesn't matter though. I just wanna quickly get it done. So this is what we have is here, and then we have the UR grid. Very well. And then end chains extend, ESJD, end settings, HMC. Very good. And the UR grid would be UR HMC grid. And this would be SS HMC grid. Then when I want to compute the ESJD, I would do something like this. I would say that I need to be careful here. So for KF then enumerate zip O do I have acceptance issues? There's also backtracks, huh? Yeah, okay. Yes, JD. Okay, my foot's gonna get a cold if I don't work faster, so that's my motivation. Uh-huh. So I'm essentially doing the exact same thing. But this is easier. This is easier because I have this here. Where, okay, refresh flag and then backtrack flag would simply be np.logical, not acc underscore. I have only one, so acc underscore would be correct. That would be correct. And then all I need to do is take all, backtrack, refresh, then put it here. Okay, and that's a G, G, G. Backtrack K, K add on, square distance, position, reflect. There's no reflect here, so we want to be careful about that. So it's the position of the, yeah. And then every time I do this, I need to have this at the bottom as well. Now maybe I shouldn't get rid of this. Let me just temporarily disable this because it could be useful. No, it's the same. Sorry. It's still gonna be the same. I'm just using it to yeah, it doesn't matter. So let me just be careful once again. Square distance, refresh plus backtrack, backtrack and refresh. And then I will call this GHMCF and then GHMC. Okay, this is a bit tricky to handle because it's not the most accurate way to write it, I think, but I think I can remember it. So this is correct. Run this, and then now my geometric jitter would be my code should be the same, right? Yeah, but of course I would need, in this case, I would need the ESJD measures, right? So still need ESJD. ESJD HMC would be equivalent to and settings HMC. Ooh, see, made mistakes already. HMC. Okay, and after everything, I would then say, okay, now this is a bit different. I could just I just need to make sure that the ratios are right, but I think the easiest way is simply actually just to a bit stupid to do it that way, but yeah. So I think it's okay. I think it's okay. So I will just say that number of settings. Okay, so it will just be plus equals to out no o pause all of it minus O pause, all of it up to the last one, up to the previous one, and all of it, I would minus this squared, and then sum across the second axis. Is that right? Let me think. So I take this, so this minus this, sum across the second axis, and I also need to sum across the first axis, don't I? Yeah. That means I have ESJD per okay, let me just quickly test out the idea without being crazy about it. Okay, so let's say ones would be say 3, 4, 5, let's call it EE, I don't know why, and then I go and then I just go this, right? I go EE. This should give me 3 values. Very good. And then I can divide them at the end for the expected jumping distance. The problem with that is because I need to save only part of the positions, which is partly why I gotta do this now, because if I don't, then I don't have time to do it later. Okay, and then similarly, I would have to have this taken care of, which is, gotta say, not so trivial. Okay, thin it, and then ESJD would be add on here, and ESJD would be add on here, and the equation here do not change, right? Okay, ESJD, there's only ESJD because there's nothing else. Okay, and this would be geometric jitter. So now when I say geometric, I'm making it correct, and then now it's exact same thing, but it's uniform. Wait, this is no jitter and then uniform jitter. With uniform jitter, LF grid, and then LF grid. So I could just put all the HMCs together, right? Let me just be completely sure about this. So no jitter looks the same as jitter, looks the same as everything else. Okay. So I would say HMC sampler, HMCJ, HMC, HMCJ, HMCJ. No, let me just say that I shouldn't really care about HMC, right? I mean, let's just be quite clear about this. Okay, so let's say jitter type, none, uniform, and geometric. So for in jitter type, could do all of this stuffs, boom, and then I say if jitter type is none, sampler type equals. HMCJ. HMC jitter type. Okay, now I might want to save this. Okay. And then so HMC, and then if okay, let me just run a short chain to make sure that it works. Okay, one sampler. This is all good. Generalize HMC. Jesus. What? What is the issue here? To be mapped? What? Oh yes, and I gotta, did I change this to AR? Okay. What the freaking hell? Number of samples. Hold up. Okay, so if I look into my, so HMCF, number of leapfrog steps, one. My equivalent HMC grid, HMC grid, LF grid, UR grid, N samples, that's correct, and then GHMC, flag, ref, pause, GHMC, F, GHMC, that's why. V-Mac got inconsistent sizes? Oh no, wait, what? Wait. Your HMC grid dot shape SS HMC, yeah. Shape. Yeah, they are the same shape. What's wrong? Flatten it, yes. Ah, that's... Dude, this is so dangerous. Should I just pause? Yeah, you see? Okay. Let's be very careful here. This is not good practice. What do we see on top? Pause init's underscore. Let's use the same nomenclature here. Pause init's underscore. Pause init's underscore. Doc dr. And the same thing here. Pause init's underscore. Pause init's underscore. Score. Da. And this is also super dangerous. Because we have to pause here. And then we can't really deal with that. Oh, actually this is not so important, but I think it's just safe anyway. Oh, what the heck? Oh my god, this is such a bad policy. But I have GD, GR, and it's on the score, and then I should be done. Okay. Oh my god, this is making me nervous. If it's none, then it's HMC, otherwise it's HMCJ. But this is giving me problems because... Why? Why again? Oh my god, this is so bad. HMCAR. Okay. And then JSMC. This give me problems because inconsistent size. Argument 1 has 900. Why is that 30 missing? Okay, let's look at here. So sampler keys 900, 1000 times 2, NF keys, argument step sizes 870. What? Argument 2, we're on to step sizes. Didn't I support set sizes? What the heck? 870. But isn't URHMC grid A70, wait, that means I'm not putting in the correct grid. UR HMC grid. Update rate. What? Wow, how do you even get number of... Oh, the position. Ah, my position should follow HMC's position. Ah, that's why. Oh my god. What a. It's a ridiculous mistake. So I should list underscore HMC. No, I'm good. Should be. Oh. Is it argument issues? But it's F. Oh, because I haven't actually implemented F. Oh shit. Yes. So what did I do? If it's F, AR refresh. Wait, AR refresh. It's my GHMC. Okay. Did I delete it? What? What? Bit weird. So you're saying that is none. It's none, there's nothing there. But why? But that's bizarre, right? Because when I do my wait, this is so weird. If sampler type is equals to GSMC. Hey, no, reverse. Oh my god, what a dumb piece of shit. Okay, then now I do this. Okay, and then this one out GHMC ref should have nothing. Rather O should have nothing. Okay. Then I can do this. Should work. Square distance is not defined. Ah, okay, my bad. I didn't define it early. Where's square distance? Square distance. Let's move it up. Let's move it here. Square distance. Hopefully this is good. Okay, idle. Very good. Now this is the tricky bit. See if it works. Invalid jittering distribution. Holy shit. What? Invalid jittering distribution. Assert if it's HMCJ, yes. So if it's none, then it's HMC. Oh shit, invalid distribution. What again? Okay, I feel like I'm just. Just making stupid mistakes. Oh shit. And hopefully it works. Right, it works. Great. Fantastic. And it should be done anytime. Ooh, it's taking a while there, my friend. What's taking so long? Ah, okay, it's done, and then I should have geom. I have geom unif. Wait. What about unif? Ah. So stupid. Okay, let me just. I feel like this is such a dangerous mistake. So underscore, 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 underscore. So freaking dumb. HMC Rosen, so there should be HMC unit, HMC unit grid here. Very good, and then the other one. Okay, then these I can just delete. Actually, yep. Very good. Very good. That's actually very good. These are just gonna temporarily comment them out so that I don't spoil any of the code, and then print saved, and then we are done. Okay, cool. So now let's run this for real. So let's run 10 chains, 10 chains of this many, update rate 30. Okay, let's be serious about this step size. Let's go to here. I figure. Wait, number update rate, what the heck? Okay, let's go here. 0.01 HMC. Hope this works. I hope this works. This should work, right? I ran it just now. It's fine. It's fine. Come on, give me chain one, and then I'll be happy. Yeah, sick. Just to make sure that I'm not doing anything crazy. true. Okay, great. Then I will just run everything. Cool, and then hopefully in a couple of hours time they'll be done. So thank you if you've been with this stream. It's kept me going. Okay, it's pretty late. I'm gonna get a quick bite and go to sleep, right? See you guys next time.